Hey everyone, today I will show you how to add loop and stream media files in Unreal Engine 5. Perfect for adding video functionality to your games. Whether you want to play local files or stream videos via URLs, this tutorial has you covered. But first, I want to introduce you to my new project called DevGames35, the same name as this channel. It's a game all about game developers and gamers. A virtual hub where developers can showcase their games and gamers can jump in and try them out. This is a community-driven project that I've been building right here, sharing progress and updates as we go. Think of it as a game made for the community, by the community, and tons of room to grow into new features and categories over time. Now that you know DevGames 3085 is all about, grab a cup of coffee and let's dive into the tutorial. We'll begin by creating a new Unreal Engine 5 project. I'm naming it DevGames 3085 to tie in with the game series we're building. For demonstration purposes, I created a video intro using videobolt.net. Start a new project and upload your custom logo. I made mine in Canva. And your game tagline. I use devgames3085.com. Adjust and preview the video, and I had to remove a black border around my logo for better results. VideoBolt offers a free version with low quality experts, but for $10 a month, you can access high quality videos. Since this is just a demonstration, I opt for the free version. To keep the project clean, I created a folder in UE5 and called it Media Screen. This will house all media files and blueprints. I saved my video as a .mp4 and placed it in the dedicated desktop folder. I drag and drop the mp4 file into the Unreal Engine. UE5 will automatically convert it to a media source file. Right click it in your Media Screen folder, Media Player. Check the box to create a media texture file. Rename it to something clear like Game Dev Textures. Double click your media player to preview the video. You'll notice the texture updates with the video content. To display the media in game, I use a TV asset from Unreal Engine's new Fab Marketplace. Import and scale. Add the TV asset to your level. Adjust its size and position as needed. Assign your media texture to the TV material and let's add the sound. Select the TV, add a media sound component, drag and assign your media player to the sound component. Now, the media won't play automatically, so we'll have to activate it using blueprints. Open the level blueprint, add a media player variable, use an open source node, assign the media source file you created earlier to the node, connect the node to begin play. Now, when you start the game, the media will play on the TV. To loop your video, in the media player settings, enable looping. Or for more control, use blueprint nodes to set the looping behavior dynamically. Want to stream a video from the web? Here's how. Use the open URL node with your media player variable. Upload your video, preferably .mp4, to an FTP server or a public web location. Paste the URL into the node. For example, I uploaded my video to my FTP server, added the URL, and it worked perfectly. And that's it. You now know how to add the play media files in Unreal Engine 5, loop your videos, and stream videos content via URLs. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like and subscribe for more Unreal Engine tips and updates on DevGame 3085, the game about developers and gamers. Want to learn how to remove hitches and improve performance in your game? Click on the video to the right and I'll show you how to get your project running smoother than ever. Happy developing, and I'll see you in the next video.